Hi guys, my name is Naman Patel and today we are going to discuss about the basics of cranial nerves, the origin of cranial nerves and of course the major functions of cranial nerves. So before starting the cranial nerves, we need to know about the types of nerves. So there are three types of nerves: the sensory, which is also known as efferent nerves, which are going to send the sensory information to the CNS, and the motor, which are going to take that information and going to act to that particular area, that is the efferent nerves or motor nerves. And the third one, which contains both the sensory and motor aspect of the nerves, and they are known as mixed nerves. So now we are ready to start about the cranial nerves. There are 12 cranial nerves. The first one is the olfactory nerve, which is sensory nerve. That is, it is going to send the information, the sensory information, to the CNS, and the sense which is going to be sent is the sense of smell. The olfactory is associated with the smell. The second one is the optic nerve. It is also a sensory nerve and it is pertaining to the vision. What we see is going to be governed by optic nerve. The third one is oculomotor nerve, which is a motor nerve. Now this nerve is going to act on the particular area. The CNS will send information and tell the motor nerve go and affect that area. Now what this oculomotor nerve do? It actually is responsible for the muscles of eyelid. Like see, if there is a storm coming, a snowstorm, let us suppose, then our eyelid will be constricted and there will only be a slit like space, and this function is governed by which nerve? Oculomotor nerve. Coming to the fifth cranial nerve, that is the trigeminal nerve. It contains both the sensory and motor part of the nerve, and the somatic sensation from the face, mouth, cornea is governed by trigeminal, and also the muscles of mastication. Mastication means if you are eating and you are the bolus is formed, the otherwise you can say it, the muscles which are chewing your food is known as the muscles of mastication. The sixth one is the abducens nerve. It is specifically a motor nerve and it is going to govern the eye movement. And these eye movements are lateral movements. Like if you are cheating in examination from your friend's copy book, then you are using the lateral movements of the eye, right? Coming next is the facial nerve. Facial nerve is both sensory and motor. That is, there are two parts of that nerve. Now, it controls the muscle of facial expression and taste from anterior tongue. It is very important feature of this nerve because see, no one would will think that facial nerve will govern the taste of anterior tongue, but it do. And about the facial expressions, when a patient is suffering from facial paralysis, what happens with him is that the facial nerve is going to be affected in that facial paralysis. That's why the facial expressions are not that much particular of that patient than the common man. Now Coming next is vestibulocochlear nerve, and it is also known as auditory nerve. It is totally sensory nerve because it is concerning with the hearing and the sense of balance. The next one is the ninth one, that is glossopharyngeal nerve. Like the word glossopharyngeal, it is going to govern the posterior aspect of the tongue and the pharynx, the superior part of the pharynx. So it is a sensory and motor nerve. Now see the function, like the name is suggested. Sensation from the posterior tongue and the pharynx. See. Now coming next is the vagus nerve. It is also sensory and motor nerve. The automatic functions of gut. The peristalsis. Actually, the peristalsis is going to be governed by the vagus nerve. The sensation from larynx and pharynx and the muscles of vocal cord and swallowing. The next one is the 11th accessory nerve. It is a motor nerve and it controls the muscles of the shoulder and neck. The 12th one is hypoglossal nerve, and it is a motor nerve and it is totally pertaining to the movements of the tongue. And friends, that is all about the cranial nerves, the introductory part of the cranial nerves. And now we will discuss about the origin of the cranial nerves. Before starting about the origin of the cranial nerves, we need to understand that some structures of the brain which can help us in understanding from where the cranial nerves arises. So firstly, we will look at them and then we will move to the origin of the cranial nerves. So there are few structures. As you can see here, it is a ventral view of the brain. It is actually a handmade diagram by me. So it is a ventral view of the brain, and you can see there is a paired structure, that is the olfactory tract, and just below it we can see the optic chiasm, where the optic nerve is going to be arised. I will talk about it later. And just below the optic chiasm we see a hole, and it is actually for the stalk of pituitary, right? Here the stalk of pituitary attaches in this hole. And just below it, we can see a paired structure. And these are known as mammillary bodies. And it ensures the posterior end of the hypothalamus, that the posterior end of the hypothalamus is nearly here, right? And see, the part from here to here, it is actually midbrain, right? So this dark space is cerebral peduncles. You can see it here. Here it is written. It is the cerebral peduncles, and here it is, right? And cerebral peduncles, there is a fact about the cerebral peduncles, you must know about it, that it is a place where diencephalon and mesencephalon meets, right? It is the place where dien and mesencephalon meets, these cerebral peduncles. Now, just below the cerebral peduncles, we can see the pons here, and there is laterally placed cerebellum, and here these two oval shaped structures are known as olives, right? And just medial to the olives we can see medullary pyramids, right? This is all about the introductory structures of the. Now we will discuss about the origin of the cranial nerves. That is actually the main part of this video, and you must see it very carefully. So now if you can see, This is a part, posterior part of a forebrain, right? This part. And just below it, there is a optic tract. This small slit is a optic tract, and just above it, there is a optic chiasm, where the optic nerve, is going to be originated from. And this is the stalk for pituitary, right guys? And just below it, two paired mammillary bodies, cerebral peduncles here, and this is a part of midbrain, I said. Just so from here, midbrain, there are two cranial nerves start, right? The first one is oculomotor, and the second one is the fourth cranial nerve, that is the trochlear. And it is important to know about the trochlear nerve is that it is the only cranial nerve which is going to be started from the posterior side of the midbrain, right? From the posterior aspect of the midbrain, that trochlear nerve is going to be originated. This is very important point, and you must remember it, right? And just below it comes here the pons. About the pons, see, it is a very important thing that pons acts like a bridging structure. There are very many bridging neurons here. That is other part of the story. We don't need to know about it right now. So here is the pons, right here. And the superior laterally, there we can find a trigeminal nerve, right? Trigeminal nerve we can find here. And just below it, here, see, it is a place where the brain stem is going to meet the, actually see, pons is bridging here, so there is no meeting, but it is a bridge like space. So at the inferior part of the pons, we can see three pairs of cranial nerves, that is the 6th, 7th and 8th, abducens, facial and vestibulocochlear. The abducens is more medially, and vestibulocochlear and facial are more laterally. Coming next to the medulla oblongata, right? If you can recognize these two structures, these are the olives, right? We just studied about them. So these are two olives here, and just above the olives, we can see a nerve originating from here, and this nerve is hypoglossal nerve, the 12th cranial nerve. See, this is the hypoglossal nerve. Now more laterally, if we see, we can see glossopharyngeal nerve, the vagus and the accessory nerves. These are originating from the lateral aspect of the medulla, right? And that is all I think about the origination of the cranial nerves. And there are few more structures, like this is the part of spinal cord. And yeah, one more thing, that at this level, right at this level, there is foramen magna. That is very important. There is foramen magna. And see, this accessory nerve is going to be inserted inside the foramen magnum, and then it will go and will terminate, not terminate, will eject out to the skull at the jugular fossa. And that is all I think about the cranial nerves, and we should now close the chapter today. Hope you will like this video, and please subscribe, like, do comment. Okay, bye guys.